must admit that I'm an odd man out here in the presence of A.K. Mittal ji here, member, and Devinder ji, and ex-chairman, and a lot of experts of railways. I represent the telecom mobile sectors. But I would like to start by first complimenting Ms. Kailash Adhikari for bringing such experts on the dais and the audience, and also having run the program for 3 years. Secondly, I would like to take this opportunity to express the sincere gratitude on behalf of all of the Indians. Railway hamari lifeline to hai hi, but how do you manage it? So many passengers, so many rails, so many demands, and we have a good leadership of 2 ministers with you and coupled with all the officers. So it's a great thing you are doing for the country, and yes, you are the lifeline for all of us. We can't think of living in India without you. Now, on the regulatory point, I have 3 points to say, one on the agony, then focus, then suggestions. Agony, I have 4 points. I'm talking something out of box, something not normally spoken on the dais. So the first agony is regulator has to be independent, neutral, competent. Whomsoever you appoint as a regulator, it will be said something against him or for him. Why this person? Why not this person? That's the first point. And by and large, most of the regulators will come from the government. If a government officer is embedded and wedded to the government for still 60 years of age, it's very difficult suddenly to change his views for the private sector. That's what we have seen in the telecom sector. Second thing we have seen is whatever best you plan, the system, the procedures, the rules, regulations, you realize within months that no, they need to be changed. Whatever best you plan. Another thing we have seen is, the third point, you decide anything on the earth, there will be criticism of saying things. Why this then, why this is not done? And last point is the consultation. Consultation is the main backbone of a regulator. But having said that, we have also seen the cases in telecom where more than 10 million or 8 million responses were filed by a particular group. So the challenge with the regulator is, does he have to go by the majority or by consensus or by whatever choice? So these are the agony in the case of regulator. Second by saying focus. Focus, we have 3 stakeholders, the government. Sir, whatever best you may say, whatever government may say, at the end of the day, it is a revenue-focused thing. You decide something which lower revenue, there will be criticism. Comes to the customer, he wants everything best in the world at nil cost. Comes to the operator, private operator, he wants the highest revenue for doing nothing on the earth. So these are the challenges with the regulator. Now, having said that, what are the suggestions? I think the one suggestion is keep in mind some initial space. Let him settle down for some time. It is difficult to think results from tomorrow. There will be some time required. Second thing is the case of selection of the chairman of the regulator. Now, in sector, we have seen lots of regulator. I think the advice which is very difficult to follow is, can we find out an officer who is bureaucrat but industrialist? We have today R.S. Sharma with us, senior bureaucrat, we all know, but he worked like an industrialist. No hang-up to meet anybody, no hang-up to go to any conference, any time, no hang-up to keep things in his mind. He's open, he will go on saying what he wants to say. He doesn't bother for anybody. Focus. The focus of this chairman is the customer. We have seen the controversies in the case of Reliance, all controversies. He stood fast, no, I am for the consumer, 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 consumer. Nothing he has changed. Nothing he has changed. And the last thing, perhaps, two things last. One is, can we think of a regulator outside the system, from an industry, or from a younger generation? From a younger generation. So that you had some box views which are not known to others. And the last thing which we faced in telecom sector is the problem of authority. What authority has the regulator? There are 2 roles. One, where he has the final authority, another recommending. Now, recommending, according to us, is the most useless authority. Because things go back to the ministry. and they don't decide even for, in our case, we have more than 100 cases, no decision taken by the ministry so far, about 100 cases. And where we are the final authority, the last challenge is, do they have the power to penalize? Thank you.